In this tutorial, I'm going to set up a grid of logos in InDesign. This logo grid will be used in a PowerPoint presentation to show off client logos. Let's get started. So here are the logos that I am going to be putting into a grid today. I have 28 logos here. My plan is to put the logos in about 4 rows on a page. So I'm quickly going to do a little math here. So I have 28 logos, and I want these logos to be in about 4 rows in my design. So I'm going to divide 28 by 4 equals 7. So I'm going to need 4 rows with 7 columns to have a really nice symmetrical logo grid. I'm going to hop over to InDesign. Okay, so I'm going to go to a new file, and I'm going to set this up. We're going to be using pixels today. This is going to be used in a PowerPoint presentation. So I want my file to be 1920 pixels by 1080. And I'm going to turn off facing pages, and I'll set everything else up in my file. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some margin to the edges. I like to have my preview button on so I can actually see the margin around here. Maybe 70 pixels. That's looking like a nice margin around the edge of the page. And let's go ahead and set up our guides. Let's go to layout, create guides. I want 4 rows, 7 columns. And I'm going to turn on my preview, and you can start to see your guides here on the page. I want my grid to be inside of my margin. So I need to say fit guides to margin instead of the page. It's going to pop that grid into the margin. I'm just going to increase my gutter to about 20 pixels each. That's the space between the columns and rows. I'm just going to bump that up just a hair more. So I'm going to click OK. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to use the rectangle frame tool. And I'm going to put a frame or a box in each of these little squares within my grid. This is just going to allow us to easily place our logos into these boxes in just a minute. So now I have 28 little boxes ready for our logos. And the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go over to my Finder window, and I'm going to simply drag and drop these logos into each of my boxes. And I'm not worried with the placement just yet. I am simply just getting them into each of the boxes for now. Once your logo's in any particular order, it's a good idea to think about that before you start dropping them. So if you wanted them in alphabetical order, you would make sure to reorder them in your Finder window ahead of time. And these logos, they're a combination of JPEGs, PNGs, some are EPS vector files, so I'm not really worried about the format today. They are mostly high res, so I don't have any that are going to be pixelated, hopefully. Now, all of my logos are now placed in these frames. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to select all of the images at once, and there's a great tool in InDesign if you have your workspace set up in the typography workspace, like I do. There's a tool at the top that allows you to take whatever image is inside of your frame and fill the frame proportionally. I like to use these tools a lot, so I'm just going to click both of these, and what it does, it essentially like shrinks the image down to fit the box that it's in proportionally. Clicking through these, you can see that the logo is all resized to get a little bit smaller, and they're starting to fit inside my box better. So the challenge with logo grids is making them all feel well proportioned, well spaced, and that none of them is feeling like overly larger than others. I do think some of these are feeling really tiny, like this one down over here is feeling tiny. And then this University of Michigan is feeling really large. So that is where we need to do some refining of these logos to make some of them smaller, some of them a little bit bigger, to better fill these spaces. I'm also not super worried about alignment of these logos. They're all so different, so there's not really an opportunity to align them all right at the top. I'm really using my grid for the alignment. So let me go back to normal mode so I can see this. And I am simply just going to go through these and just start enlarging some of them and making some of them smaller. And a quick note, I am using this selection tool, the direct selection tool, to select the actual image itself, not the box around it. to make these adjustments. Okay, this USDA is really large. I'm going to make it a little bit small. Michigan, very big. Yeah, so again, visually, I'm just kind of going through these, and anything that's feeling too large and like it's taking over the space, I'm just trying to make it feel more proportionate to the others. And again, I'm using my guide, so nothing is going outside of these little boxes here. So this one's very light, very white, so it's not, it doesn't have quite the same visual weight as the others, so I'm making it bigger. I like to use the squint test a lot on this kind of project. The squint test is where you literally squint your eyes and you start to see your design more in like blurry forms than actually what's on the page. And that really helps you show like where is the visual weight in your design. I'm seeing this bottom row is still feeling a little visually heavy when I'm doing the squint test. So I'm just going to make a few of these logos just a tad smaller. And overall, I'm feeling like this looks really good. Nothing is feeling overly large and like it's dominating any of these squares right now. So that's feeling really good. So what I would do next is I would save my file. If I'm putting this in a PowerPoint, I'm also going to export a JPEG. Now let's look at our finished product. Again, this is a logo grid with 28 logos in it. These all feel really well spaced, very symmetrical overall, and this would work really great just placing this in a PowerPoint. So thanks for watching this tutorial. Subscribe to Crye Studio for more graphic design and InDesign tutorials. Thanks so much.